Hi guys, and welcome to another Divi WordPress theme tutorial. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, in our last video we did this sort of grayscale to color hover effect with zoom here. In this one, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a bit of text to these modules that's going to appear when we zoom. And while I'm doing that, I'm going to disable this zoom because it'll just make things easier to work on. So I'm going to go back into my theme options and just comment out some of this CSS here by going /*, and /* over that too, or */ to finish the comment. There we go, I'll just save that. That should stop it zooming for the time being. Okay, let's just refresh that. Yeah, that's better. So I'm going to add a text module. At the moment, these are just columns with an image in the background of the columns with actually no content in the columns. I'm now going to add some content. So I'll have to change the padding there. So let's enable the Visual Builder. And once it's enabled, we'll go down. Here's our little row with our four different columns in it. Let's add an item. I'm just going to add a text item. Scroll down to the text. There it is. Okay, and let's add a little title. What I'll do is I do my usual little cheat. So I really haven't got any text in mind for this. I'll make that a heading 3. Okay, so what we've got a little text module in between here now, and our columns actually got padding top and bottom. I'm going to remove that now that we've got something inside it. We had to put some padding in there to make it as tall so we could display the image. So I'm going to remove that by going on the row cog and going to design, spacing, and here we are. And you should see it just shrink down to the size of the text module itself there, which is fine. I'm removing this from all the columns. We're on column 3 now and column 4. There we go. So as you can see, they reverted to the size of the actual text column itself. All right, so let's style this text column. We're going to go on its little module cog right here. And I'm going to go up to design, spacing. I'm going to give it on a margin on the top, push it down, and I'm going to give it a margin of say 50%. That way it should stay similar when the image enlarges. Okay, that's fine, and let's give it some padding of 25 all round, I guess. There we go, that's giving the content a bit of padding all round. I'm going to get rid of a little bit of that content. I've got more than I want in there. So let's take some of this off. I really only want a couple of lines. That's more like it, something like that. That'll be plenty. But as you can see, it's a little difficult to read. So we want to give it perhaps a background color and make that text light. So let's go to background. We'll give it a gradient. And the gradient color will make it solid black at the bottom. And we'll use black again at the top, but we'll bring the opacity down so it's more like a regular gradient. Then I'm going to play, oh, I don't quite want as much as that, with the starting position and ending position. Well, I've got something that I like. Yeah, I think that's going to work. It's a real dark at the bottom, but it's enough at the top there. I'm going to make that text white that it should stand out nicely. So if we go to design, we'll go to text, and we'll make that text light. Text color. Just change that to light. There we go. That stands out quite nicely, and I think that's fairly legible. You can always bring it up a little bit more. I'll change that gradient a little bit more if you want to. What else do we want to do here? I think that's probably going to do it. Okay, that's fine. But actually, on the non-hover, so I only want this to appear when we're hovering over it. So what I'm going to do is give this element, our text element that we've just created here, I'm going to give it a class. CSS class or an ID if you want to. I'm going to use a class here and we'll just call it TZM for text zoom. Call it whatever you want, just remember what you've called it. And what I'm going to do is write some custom CSS, and I'm going to have this invisible until we hover over it. And it's pretty easy to do. Let's just save this. And once it's saved, we'll exit the Visual Builder. And what I'm going to do is I'll write the CSS that'll make that disappear, and then we'll do some hover CSS to make it reappear. So here's that stuff I commented out before. I'm actually going to, well, I'll leave that. I'll leave it out for a moment. We'll put it back in a minute. I'm going to put this below this. And what was it? TZM, wasn't it? Tech Zoom. So, and open and close some curly brackets. And to make it disappear, I'm going to say opacity, or opacity, however you like to say it, 0. That should make it invisible, but it'll still be there. It'll still be taking up that space, so that image will still be the same height. Whereas if we said display none, that would make it disappear, and the image would pretty much disappear because there'd be no height to it. Also, when you hovered over it, you wouldn't be hovering over anything because it wouldn't exist. So opacity is the way to go. And what I'll do is I'm going to copy that from the dot to the curly bracket, drop down a couple, paste it in there, and on the dot TZM I'm going to write colon hover. No space between the colon and the hover. That's really important. It will not work if you do that. And I'm going to change that value to 1, which is full opacity or fully viewable. So it's solid. And you can do 0.1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 to the amount that you want it to. That's fully visible. That's invisible. Let's save my changes. And refresh the page. It should disappear when I refresh. Yep, it's disappeared. Now if I hover over it, that text and the overlay should reappear. There it is. But as with things before, it's appearing instantly. I really don't want it to do it. I want it to sort of gradually come in, say over a second and a half, like we did with the zoom effect earlier on. So let's add a bit of transition CSS in the main class, not the hover class, in the main class. So I'm going to say transition. And we'll give it, what did I say, about a second and a half, something like that. And we want it to do it with everything in there. So it's transition all, 1.5 seconds. And we'll have it ease in, ease dash in dash out. So it sort of gradually comes in, it's in, then you let go of it with the mouse, it eases back out again. And put a semicolon on the end of that. Quick save, see what we got going on here. Back to the page and a refresh. Shouldn't see any change initially. Now when we hover over it, that should appear, but take about a second and a half to appear. That's a bit more like, it's more gradual that way. I just think it looks a bit better if you do it like that. Okay, job done. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this text block over to these, because we still actually got things there. That's what your column with an image background looks like when there's nothing in it. So let's put something in it. We'll copy this. Let's enable the visual builder again. And after I've done this, what I'll do is go in and re-enable that zoom effect, and it should happen for all our modules there. Okay, so here we go. Here's our text block. Let's copy it. And I can't see it because I'm not zoomed on it. You have to be on it to actually see it. And let's just move it over to here. And we'll do the same thing here. Copy two little blocks there. Take it, move it over to here. And one more time. We can't see it until we zoom over it. All right, there we go. So we've got. Now that's fine. If you want to leave it like that, that's great. You've just got a little text overlay effect going on. But let's re-enable the CSS we had before, where it starts off as grayscale and then it zooms in with color, and see what happens. So we'll save this. And once it's saved, we'll exit the visual builder. And let's go to our options, to our CSS again. Now let's take that little closing comment tag, the star forward slash off the end of here. And let's take the one off just before the .zm here, one we put on. There we are, and it's colored now, so it's all active. Save our changes. Go back to our page and refresh. Now, when they, as you can see, they've already gone grayscale. Now, when we hover over these, they should scale up to 2 times the size like they were doing before. Plus, if we hover over that text block, it will do that as well. So let's try. There we go. That text has come in. You can have it hover without. Or if you just roll down a bit more, your text will appear again. We can have it hover, no text, just roll down to the text block and it will appear. Or if you put your mouse in the middle or somewhere on the text block, it'll just grow with the text as well. And as you can see, that's taking a second and a half to do all that. Go from gray to color and for your little text block to appear. If we pull one in with no text, let's see. And scroll down, it should take about a second and a half. Yeah, there we go. Eases in, eases out, eases in, eases out. So there you go, little extension of what we had going on there. So that's how easy it is to put a text overlay with a gradient background on your image. I hope you found that useful. If you have, please like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you're interested in web development, take a look down below. We've got some great courses down there, some great free courses, also some great premium courses down there with some huge discounts for our YouTube subscribers. So do take a look. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.